How to save something from the dotnet MAUI community toolkit drawing view into an image. That is what we're going to see in this video. Earlier on this channel, I've made a video on how to get started with the drawing view, which is a control in the dotnet MAUI community toolkit, which allows you to basically draw anything on a canvas. So think of maybe, I don't know, some app there where you can have to do Pictionary. That's the game, right? Where you have to kind of guess what the drawing is going to be, or maybe much more practical, having a signature pad where your customer has to sign something in the app. But I've got a couple of questions under my videos, which I always welcome. So if you have something in this video or another question, let me know down in the comments about how to actually save an image from that drawing view. So in this video, we're going to see how to get all the data from the drawing view and put it inside of an image as a PNG and save that to your device or file, and then you can process it further. So let's hop into Visual Studio. Here in Visual Studio, I've loaded the sample code for my drawing view video. You can find the link down below that will also contain the code that I'm going to write right now, because all my videos have a GitHub sample attached, so go check that out in the video description. Here you can see it running on Windows, and this little gray box is the area, the canvas that I can actually draw. So on Windows, I can use my mouse cursor, and I already implemented whenever you have drawn a line that it will show the image in an image control in dotnet MAUI. So that's how to do that, and from there it's actually a little step to also save it to a file. So we're going to implement that here on the on click button that we can see here. I'm going to show you for Windows, Android, and iOS, so all the platforms that are here. So let me close this for a little bit and we can inspect the code that's already here. We have this little image that I've implemented in the previous video. I highly recommend that you check out that one first so that you know all about the drawing view and what it can do for you. But here we have this image, and there we load the image that is resulting from the drawing view that you can see right here, which is a control in the dotnet MAUI community toolkit. I'm giving it a background, a width request, a height request. On Windows, it's a little bit small, but it's fine for now. Multi-line mode enabled. We don't allow multiple lines. The line color is green. The line width, you can have all these configuration options on how your drawing thing is going to look like, or you can let the user influence that by setting the color and let them make a little drawing thing. So that's really cool. We don't really need this label, so actually let me just remove this one. And this button, let's name this not click me, but save image. And we already have this clicked event handler wired up here. So on counter clicked, I'm just going to leave the name there. It doesn't really matter. It's all sample code. So let's go to our main page, xaml.cs. And you can here see that whenever a line is completed, which is an event from the drawing view, we're going to get the stream, which is kind of important. We're going to get the stream, and we're going to load that into an image source from stream, use that stream, and it's going to be shown in an image. But we can also use that stream to do all kinds of other stuff. You can send it to a backend if that's what you want. You can save it to a file, and that's exactly what we're going to do right now. So this on counter clicked, let's remove all the code that's here. Let's remove this redundant count field because we are not using it. And in here, we're going to implement the code to actually save this to a file. Now, file system, we have a file system helper, file system in dotnet MAUI directly, which has a couple of things, but it doesn't have the thing that I actually want to do here. This only gives you some information about the app data directory, the cache directory, which is very useful, but not for what we're trying to do. So accessing the file system and saving a file is kind of file specific, platform specific stuff. So I'm going to do a couple of compiler directives here. So I'm going to say if Windows is the easiest one. Then I'm going to say else if, which is L if Android, and then lastly, L if iOS, and you can probably add Mac Catalyst here as well, so that we have them all, and then we do end if. So this is an easy way. This is enabled by the dotnet MAUI single project approach to write platform-specific code right inside of your code here. You can definitely do it other ways, neater ways, if this is not what you like to do, litter your code with these compiler directives, but this is an easy way to, you know, make some side steps for different platforms here and there. So that's really cool. So for Windows, like I already said, it's pretty easy. We're just going to basically say you have system.io.file, and you can save all the bytes, right? But the first thing we need to do, and this is in our shared code, so if you don't put it in these compiler directives, we can do some shared code. So I can just do var stream, you've already seen that down below for the drawing view, is await draw view. So that draw view is my name for the drawing view here, right? If we go back to the example, you can see here that I have this X name of draw view. So that's just my reference to this element right here. Draw view dot get image stream. And you can specify a width and a height. So this is just 200 by 200. Let's make it a little bit more impressive by making it 1024, 1024, and we have our stream, right? It will get the image stream with all the drawings on top of it, and we will have that. Another way that you can do this, we also have the drawing view dot, and we don't have the right using here, so use community toolkit MAUI views. If we add that, we can do drawing views, and we can also do get image stream. So this is the static instance, the static method, but now you have to suddenly provide the lines. So you can also provide a custom set of lines, right, for this drawing, or you can just get the draw view dot lines. There we go. So we get this lines collection. So if you want to maybe use it in a more data binding way, you will just bind those lines of the draw view lines, and you can call this static instance of drawing view, and you can use it in a more MVVM kind of way, right? So we have these lines. You still need to do a size. So new size is 1024, right? So that's the same as what we see in the line above. And then we can say the background, right? So you can set a background color. Well, actually, we have to do colors dot, I don't know, red, something like that, right? So we can set a custom background color because we don't have the background color from the draw view, right? If you're just calling this get image stream on the draw view instance, so this control right here in the XAML, it's going to get the background color that we set here, which is in this case light gray. So that's how that all works together. You can use this get image stream like this as well, but I'm just going to use that actual instance that we have here. Then what you want to do is get a you probably want to do this stream as a using as well, because, you know, streams are always, you have to clean them up, and if you don't do that, then they will keep resources and you will create a memory leak. So do a using here, and we also do a use var memory stream, because if we really want to get the bytes, then a memory stream is the easiest thing. Is new memory stream, so we create a new one, and then we're going to say memory stream, well, no, actually stream dot copy to. We're going to copy everything from our stream to the memory stream, so that we also have it in our memory stream like this. Then we probably want to set the stream dot position, because if you're going to read through a stream, it's going to read to the end, and then the position is going to be the end one. We want to reset the position here also for the memory stream, so that if we're going to do this again, if we're going to save these, then the position has to be zero, because it's going to go through that stream again, the methods that we're going to call here to actually save all the bytes. So we want to set the positions to zero, just to be sure. Now for Windows, it's quite easy. Make sure that you have this box right here set to Windows, so that we're living in Windows land here. And we're going to say system.io. I'm using the full namespaces here, because else I would have to repeat all these compiler flags here. So in the usings here at the top as well, if Windows, then using system.io, etc., etc. So again, that's choices that you want to make, but I'm just going to do it this way. That file, and then I'm going to say write all bytes. You probably want to do it async. Actually, write all bytes async. Let's just do that, because this is async already. So write all bytes async. And then I have to specify the file path. So let's just do C users, my username, desktop, and drawing view. And I know it's going to be a PNG, so let's just make this test. Dot png. There we have it. And it's not going to know these slashes, so you can either duplicate the slashes, or you can add a at sign here so that it will pick up automatically as well. And then I have to specify the bytes that I actually want to write here. So I want to specify the memory stream dot to array, because that will get me the bytes. And I need to await this, of course, so I need to do await to actually do this, make this awaitable. So now I have everything to write it on Windows. Windows is kind of easy, right? Windows lets you write to the file system. So if I'm going to do this, I'm going to run this on Windows. I can do my little drawing, and then when I click the save file, then it's going to write all the bytes to this little test.png here. So my application is coming up. I'm going to make the best drawing that you've ever seen. This actually says subscribe to my channel. So this this is your signal. If you haven't subscribed to my channel just yet, find the subscribe button down below and do it now. And then when I click save image, it's going to save the image. I didn't really give any feedback, so this is not really great user experience, but oh well. Here in the folder though, we can now see this test.png. And whenever I double click it, it's going to open this viewer. And we have the little image now here as a file. So that's pretty cool, right? We have this on Windows, so that's working. Now we need some code for Android. And as is usually the case, Android needs a lot of code. Android has some weird things here. So I'm going to copy and paste some code on here. Don't be alarmed. It's a lot. And we have, boom, our code for Android here as well. You can see it's grayed out. If we switch again here to the different target platform here for Android in the top left, then you can see that Windows gets grayed out, and now we have all of our code for Android. This is going to get our current activity. Activity is just your screen, your thing on Android. We're going to use a content resolver. Now note this API that you see here is kind of newish. There is a deprecated API that you need to use for older Android versions. I will include that in the final code that you'll find on the GitHub repository, but this is the most up-to-date code. And you can see that we use this content resolver. We're adding some metadata, so we're setting the display name, which is test.png, the MIME type, the relative path where we're going to save it, and do some other things right here. And then we're actually going to get that bitmap from our stream. So here we can use the regular stream. I could have, you know, taken in this memory stream code into the Windows one, maybe. I need it for iOS as well. Then we're going to do bitmap compress. We're going to save it as a PNG, 100% quality. We're going to flush and close to clean up all the resources. And now it also works on Android. Now I'm not going to deploy it on Android. I already have it here on the emulator. So it's running here. You can see that same square. It actually hasn't deployed with the save me here. So this says click me, but this is the exact same code otherwise. And whenever I do this little drawing right here, again, this says subscribe to my channel, really weird, but that's what it is in Dutch. So click this button and now it's saved in the background to a file. And it's going to be picked up kind of like with the media features of your Android device. So if I switch to the folders, the files and folders explorer here on Android that I have installed on this emulator, it takes a little while before this refreshes. Maybe I can do it manually. And here you can see it pop up the test.png with the drawing that I've just saved. So we can also do this on Android. Cool, cool, cool. Now for iOS, again, it's pretty easy to actually do this, to just save something to the gallery. So I'm just going to paste this code in here again and switch to iOS land. And here we can just create a new image, UIKit, UI image with NS data from array. I'm going to use that memory stream again. See, there it is again. And I'm going to say image.save to photos album. You probably want to do something with this error whenever something comes up that you detect the error. But otherwise, it should just save it to the photos album. You probably do need the permissions for this to actually do something like this. So again, I will double check that, make sure that's in the GitHub repository code. But this is all there is to it, to actually save a file to, well, no, save a drawing to a file. Well, that wasn't too bad, was it? It just is the one of those things that you kind of like need to know how to do it. But once you know it, then there is a lot of power in here, because now you can save these files or you can upload them to some kind of API. You probably want to do that through the stream directly and not maybe save the file first and send that, because then you have to save that file to a stream again and then stream that to, well, anyway. You get the idea, right? So you can save this to APIs, you can save this on the local device, you can maybe, I don't know, put this on a PDF automatically if that's what you want. So there is lots of options that you can do with this, which is really amazing. So like I said at the beginning of this video, if there is something still unclear, if you have other questions, please let me know down in the comments, or just let me know how nice this video was. And if you actually thought this video was nice, then please click the like button to actually enforce that and let the YouTube algorithm know to other people, this is the video to watch. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so already, and I'll be seeing you for my next video, but not before I tell you that this playlist has a couple of more .NET MAUI videos, so be sure to check that out, and this video is recommended especially for you. See you for the next video.